Hello everyone, my name is Iris France, 我叫连婉如. Today we're going to talk about price ceiling. So the definition of price ceiling is a legal maximum price at which a good, service, or resource can be sold. Now, if a price ceiling is above the equilibrium price, then it is not binding and it will not affect the market. So use analogy, think about the ceiling above our head. Our ceiling is above our head, so you don't notice it and it does not affect you. And similarly, if a price ceiling is above our equilibrium price, then it is not binding and it will not affect the market. Now, if a price ceiling is lower than the equilibrium price, then it is binding and it will create a shortage. So think about our ceiling. If it's below our head, then we're going to bump our head. And that's not good. So that's an analogy. Now we're going to move on to the price ceiling that is not binding. So look at this diagram. We have our equilibrium price and quantity, P star and Q star. Now suppose the government sets a price ceiling, PC. That means any price that is above PC will be off limit. So any gray area, we cannot go there. Now you will say, that's fine. Our price is P star. Our quantity is Q star. So does it affect our market? The answer is no. It does not affect our market. Our equilibrium price is still P star. Our equilibrium quantity is still Q star. So you can see that price ceiling that is above our equilibrium price is not binding and it will not affect our market. Now I'm going to change the scenario. Suppose now we have a price ceiling that is below our equilibrium price. So you can see that any price that is above PC will be off limit. Now it is going to affect us. Why is that? Because you're not allowed to sell at price P star anymore. So the price will be PC. Given price PC, your quantity supplied is going to be here. How do I know that? Because given price PC, you go to your supply curve and it tells you quantity supply is here. And given price PC, you go to your demand curve, it tells you that your quantity demanded is there. So quantity demanded is higher than quantity supplied, and therefore you have a shortage. And therefore, a price ceiling that is set below equilibrium price is binding and it will create a shortage. Now we're ready to take a look at an example. Now, suppose there is a rent control mandate in the city of Denver, Colorado. So suppose our equilibrium rent is $2,000 and our government comes in and set the maximum rent at $1,500. Now, in that case, you can see that, hey, quantity supplied is here. Quantity demanded is there. So quantity demanded is higher than quantity supplied, and therefore we have a shortage. Now, when you want to rent a unit and the agent tells you, sorry, we don't have a unit right now, but we will put you on the wait list. If you have a wait list, that means, hey, there is a shortage. So you have to a waiting line. So you can see that there will be a shortage. And when there is a shortage, that means the landlords can pick and choose their tenants. Now, when the landlord can pick and choose their tenants, that means there is a possibility of discrimination against minorities. So that's one drawback of the rent control. And another issue of rent control is black market. So you can see that the demand curve reflects the willingness to pay. Now, given the quantity is QS being so low, then you go back to your demand curve. You can see that the tenants are willing and able to pay up to $2,500 for a rental unit, given such a small quantity. So you can imagine that there could be landlords out there, they are trying to make this kind of money. So they can tell their tenants, you know what, I have a unit, but you want that unit, you will have to pay me cash, and then you don't tell anyone. You have to pay me $2,500. So you can see that's black market. And that's another drawback of rent control. And also, there's an issue of lower quality rental units. You can imagine there will be law-abiding landlords out there who are charging only $1,500. But you can imagine that equilibrium rent is $2,000. That means the landlords will need $2,000 in order to properly repair their rental units. So given the rent being so low, $1,500, the landlords will say, I cannot afford to repair this unit, so I'm not going to repair them. So you can imagine that the rental units, the quality will become lower. And finally, there will be allocation inefficiency. So what does that mean? You can imagine that in the past, when the rent was $2,000, the equilibrium rent, then unless your willingness to pay is greater than or equal to $2,000, then you're not going to rent a unit because the price is $2,000. But now with the rent ceiling, if your willingness to pay is higher than $1,500, then you're going to go ahead and try to get a rental unit. Now, suppose we have two tenants. Tenant number one, his or her or their willingness to pay is $1,800. And tenant number two, his or her or their willingness to pay is $2,000. Now, because there is a shortage, now suppose tenant number one gets into the line earlier than tenant number two. Then tenant number one is going to get a rental unit, but tenant number two is not going to get a rental unit. Now you can see that our goods and services are not allocated to the consumers with the highest willingness to pay. So you can see that tenant number two has a higher value than tenant number one, but because tenant number two gets in the line a little bit later than tenant number one. So tenant number one gets a unit, but not tenant number two. So you can see that that's not efficient. And if you're interested, you can listen to Freakonomics Radio on rent control. That is episode number 373. And you can go ahead and listen to that if you're interested. Finally, the summary of price ceiling is this. If your price ceiling is above equilibrium price, then it is not my thing and it will not affect the market. Just think about our ceiling above our head. We don't bump our head and our ceiling does not affect us. But if your price ceiling is below the equilibrium price, then it is binding and it will create a shortage. Just like our ceiling, if it's too low, lower than the position of our head, then we'll bump our head and it creates a problem. So this concludes our price ceiling. I hope this helps. We'll see you next time.